Hello friends, welcome to my channel Skill on Tech. I am NK Jain and I will show you a video and discuss about hydraulic thrust of centrifugal pump and compressors. Freshers and engineering students of mechanical and chemical must have knowledge about hydraulic thrust and what are the measures of balancing hydraulic thrust in pumps and compressors. Video become very interesting, hence please see the complete video. And if you like the video, please share it with your friends and colleagues. In this video, we will discuss about only hydraulic thrust and how it is produced. But in the upcoming videos, we will discuss about the measures to balance the hydraulic thrust in pumps and compressors. What is hydraulic thrust? During operation and working of centrifugal pumps and compressors, the high pressure fluid trapped between the impeller and casing, which exert pressure on the outlet wide passage and shrouds of the impeller, resulting in generation of two thrusts. One is radial thrust and other one is axial thrust. The radial thrust produced due to unbalance of hydraulic forces in the radial direction of impeller, and axial thrust is produced in the impeller of pumps and compressors parallel to rotor. Radial thrust in centrifugal pump impeller. In this slide you can see a picture of two different type of volute casings of a centrifugal pump. Here you can see this is a single volute design casing and this is a double volute design casing. In a single volute design casing, in a centrifugal pump, a radial thrust is produced due to different areas in the volute casing discharge pipeline path. You can see in this picture that area of a discharge path is getting widened. So, the forces acting due to discharge pressure are different. Here, the area is more, pressure is more, so the radial thrust is getting produced. So this is the reason in a single volute design casing that radial thrust produced due to discharge path is creating unbalanced radial forces. These unbalanced radial forces are reduced up to some extent in double volute design casing. This is a double volute design casing. Here you can see the casing is split. So the area of this discharge path is made similar. So the forces produced during discharge of liquid due to discharge pressure are similar all around the periphery of the impeller shrouds. So the radial thrust which is produced is balanced up to some extent with a provision of double volute design casing. As we have discussed that during operation of centrifugal pumps and compressors, axial thrust is produced and that axial thrust is a reason for movement of the impeller and rotor in axial direction. So let us see how this axial thrust affects on the impeller and rotor assembly. This is a canned motor pump, and you can see here in this picture this impeller is rotating and suction is coming from this side axially to the impeller eye, and this is discharge. Now you can see the discharge side, there is a high pressure. This is a discharge pressure of the pump, which is produced when impeller kinetic energy is transferred to the liquid. And the suction side is a low pressure. Due to differential pressure across the impeller, impeller and rotor move axially. Let us see how it moves. Now you can see the impeller is moving towards the suction side because discharge pressure is high. So axial thrust is tending to move the shaft towards low pressure side. You can also see there is a clearance between impeller and impeller casing. So the high pressure produced due to centrifugal force is pass through the clearance volume towards suction side. So what happens? Due to passing of this high pressure fluid towards the suction side, the pressure of suction side also increases and the thrust is trying to balance. So impeller will try to come to its original position. You can see the movement of the impeller shaft. Now it has trying to come back to the discharge side again. So now you can see this complete assembly is designed and assembled in such a way that rotating parts or moving parts should not interact with the stationary parts. So this all is taken care during design of the centrifugal pumps and compressors. Similarly, in centrifugal compressors axial thrust is produced, and that is also taken care by the thrust bearings. Axial thrust in high pressure centrifugal compressors. You can see a picture in this presentation of an impeller where it is shown that there is a variation in gas momentum at compressor impeller blade, as well as volute casing of a centrifugal compressor have a variation in areas of discharge path. Therefore, the radial and axial thrusts are produced which act on the impeller. So let us know the reasons. The centrifugal compressor faces residual axial thrust acting on the rotor of a centrifugal compressor is due to result of non-uniform pressure distribution on the impeller with the process gas. Differential pressure acting on the faces of the impeller and the contribution due to the momentum variation of process gas. Here you can see this is a one side and this is another side. So there are two sides. One is a suction side, other is a discharge side. So there is always a differential pressure acting on the compressor impeller. Due to this, the axial thrust is produced. And due to momentum of gas is also having two components. One is a horizontal component, you can see in this picture, and one is a vertical component. So these two also act of the gas upon the impeller, which are also causing production of radial and axial thrust. During the design phase, the axial load kept to remain safely lower than the thrust bearing capacity under all possible operating conditions. This is essential parameter to evolute thrust load to have long life of thrust bearings. So, the thrust load what is produced is calculated very exactly to provide sufficient design thrust bearings to take load of thrust which is produced by the compressor. The bearings which are provided are always having a greater capacity of thrust load which is produced by the compressor. Effect of hydraulic thrust. You can see a picture of a closed impeller here. The thrust load has many detrimental effects on impeller and life of pump and compressor bearings. Because whatever thrust is produced by impeller due to differential pressure across the impeller is to be taken by the bearings, the higher reaction on bearings reduced life of bearing. If reaction is greater than the design of bearing capacity, then bearings will not survive and it will worn out and damage very quickly. The thrust load may cause shaft bending also. Shaft can also bend. This may also cause seal faces close in pumps and due to wear and tear promote leakages. If there is a greater thrust load, then seal faces, if there are two seal faces, so they will also come closer. And heat will produced and seal faces will worn out and start leaking. So therefore, the hydraulic thrust is a very important factor to be considered in design of pumps. How to manage thrust in pumps and compressors? The hydraulic thrust of radial and axial are balanced with the help of bearings and additional measures in pump and compressors. The bearings may be of following types: deep groove ball bearings, suitable only for taking radial loads; angular contact and self-aligned bearings, they can take thrust load also; journal bearings, sleeve type and thrust bearings. Journal bearings are only suitable for taking radial load, but thrust bearings are suitable for taking axial thrust load. Additional measures in pump to balance thrust, such as axial thrust, such as balance disc, balance drums, pump out vane, balance hole in impeller, double volute casing, diffuser casing, etc. So all measures are taken for balancing the radial and axial thrust. In compressors, balance piston is used to balance thrust in addition to thrust bearings. We will discuss in detail in upcoming videos regarding how to manage thrust in pumps and compressors, what type of bearings are used, what type of volute casings are provided to balance radial thrust. That will be discussed in upcoming videos and it will become very interesting to know. That is all for this video. Thank you for watching this video. If you like it, please hit the like button below and share with your friends and colleagues. Please leave your questions, comments and feedback in section below. Thank you.